my dear students, how are you? Miss Anna misses you so much. Before we proceed to our lesson for today, let's have a short warm-up activity. Let's sing a song. The song is entitled Fight Song.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single
make
a heart open. I might only have one chance, but I can make an explosion. And all the things I didn't say, breaking balls inside my brain. I will scream them loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight.
For today. What can you see? What can you say about the picture? Where is it? Yes. This place is a beach. How about the next picture? What can you say about the season and the weather? What are the two children doing? Great! It is summertime. These two children are playing and having fun. Now, do you think they are on a vacation? Yes, they are. Now, let's think and discuss about the word vacation. Who can give me another term for the word vacation? Very good. Holidays. When we say vacation, what comes into your mind? Great. It's about the special days like your Chinese New Year's. And to celebrate holidays. And of course, when you say vacation, you're having a rest and relax because this is the time off from work and school. Now, this word vacation is related to our lesson for today because we are going to read a story. And that story is entitled How I Spent My Summer Vacation by Mark Teague. Now, before we proceed to the story, let's meet the author. Who is Mark Teague? Mark Teague was born on February 10, 1963 in La Mesa, California. He describes most of his books as imaginary journeys. He says he gets many of his ideas from the children he meets. Mark Teague taught himself how to draw. He says that with each project he learns something new. He said, I start with something I remember from my childhood for all the stories I do. And he did a lot of drawing as a kid. Therefore, Mark Teague is also an illustrator. Now, let's discuss about the genre of the story. What do you think? Can you make a guess? What is the genre of this story? Do you think it's a real story? Okay, the genre of this story is fantasy. A fantasy is a story that could not really happen. And we're going to look for the characters who do things real people cannot do, because it's a fantasy story. And the setting that may be different from the real world. Now let's proceed with the vocabulary. Number one, captured. Please repeat after me. Captured. Very good. Now what's the meaning of the word captured? It means to control over. For example, the fish captured the man. Say the word one more time. Captured. Captured. Next word is imagination. 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 What's the meaning of the word imagination? This means the ability to think of things that aren't real. For example, it takes a good imagination to write stories about fairies. Say the word once again. Imagination. Next word is Can you read the word? Manners. Say it again. Manners. Manners means polite ways to behave. Now look at the picture of this little boy. This boy needs to practice good table manners. Let's go to the next word. Who can try to read this word? Matador. Repeat after me. Matador. Matador is a bullfighter. It is dangerous to be a matador. Now please read the sentence. Very good. Next word is planes. Planes. Planes are flat areas of land. If you're going to use it in a sentence, here is the example. Many planes are good for growing grain. Later on, after finishing this lesson, you can use these words in a sentence. Next word is relax. Relax. Can you please read the meaning of the word relax? Have fun doing very little. For example, the kitten is relaxing on his pillow. The next word is vacation. Vacation. When we say vacation, it is a time off from work or school. The family is going on a vacation to the beach. Can you make your own sentence using the word vacation? Very good. Now, let's try to evaluate your understanding or comprehension about the vocabulary. But before that, I want you to repeat the words twice. Captured, captured. Imagination, imagination. Manners, manners. Matador, matador. Planes, planes. Relax, relax. Vacation, vacation. Now you're going to complete the sentence and choose the correct word. Now look at the picture. This will be a clue. It will be a big help for you to get the correct answer. Let's read the sentence. A plum uses a red cake. What is your answer? Awesome. A matador uses a red cake. Now, can you please tell me what a matador is? Can you still remember? Terrific. A matador is a bullfighter. Say it again. Bullfighter. Matador. Bullfighter. Very good. Let's go to the next sentence. Our family is going on a Disney cruise for Plant this year. So what is your answer? Good. Vacation. Can you please read the whole sentence? Our family is going on a Disney cruise for vacation this year. How about the next sentence? Look at the picture. Please read the sentence. These children are learning to use good plan at the tea party. good blank, what will be your answer? Great. The answer is manners. Do you still remember? Manners means polite way or ways to behave, like table manners. Let's go to the next. Look at the picture. Do you know what animals are these? Now, let's read the sentence. Native Americans who lived on the plant hunted buffalo. So the answer will be plains. Let's go to the next. You're doing great. Can you please read the sentence? Use your blank to go on a magic carpet ride with me. And the answer will be imagination. You're going to use your imagination to go on a magic carpet ride with me. Look at the magic carpet. Next one. Try to remember the meaning of each word. Look at this cat. A cat does not like to blank in a bubble bath. Okay, the answer will be relax. Why do you think a cat doesn't like to relax in a bubble bath? Okay. So these choices are the vocabulary in this story. This will be the last one. Now the boy is proud that he blanked the fish. Do you think the answer is matador? No. Relax? No. He captured the fish. Very good. Okay, for the last evaluation, just for to check your mastery about the vocabulary of the story, let's match the meaning to the word. I know that you can do it. Just try to remember and focus. Now, in number one, the word is vacation. So you need to look for the meaning of the word vacation. So these are the choices from letters A to G. Vacation. What is your answer? So let's try to read first the choices. Okay? Letter A, took control over. Letter B, the ability to think of things that are real. Letter C, polite ways to behave. Letter D, have fun doing very little. Letter E, time off from work or school. Letter F, bullfighter. Letter G, flat open areas of land. So for vacation, your answer will be, of course, letter E, time off from work or school. Number two, what is your answer number two? Think about your answer. Don't just make a guess. Try to understand. Nice. The answer will be letter C, polite ways to behave. Have an imagination. Great. It's letter B, the ability to think of things that aren't real. And for the word captured, letter A, took control over. And for the matter, of course, I think you know this very well. Bullfighter, letter F. And for the cleanse, it's letter G, flat open ears of lamb. And for the last word, relax, it means letter D, have fun doing very little. Now, let's review all the vocabulary words and their meanings. Read the vocabulary twice, and for the meaning, only once. Vacation, vacation. Time off from work or school. Manners, manners. Polite ways to behave. Imagination, imagination. The ability to think of things that aren't real. Captured, captured. Took control over. Matador, matador. Bullfighter. Plains, plains. Flat open areas of land. Relax, relax. Have fun doing very little. So for your homework, you're going to use each vocabulary in a sentence. If you can make 2 to 3 sentences, then it's better. Try to practice reading the vocabulary and try to remember the meaning of each vocabulary. Okay, have a great day.